VFC, welcome to our end of year service at VFC. I hope you've had a lovely Christmas. I don't know about you, but this time between Christmas and New Year is a bit odd, and it's a bit disorientating. No one knows what day of the week it is, what we should be doing, but I hope that you're enjoying this season. You know, this year has been like this period of time. It's been very disorientating. You know, 2022 has seen us have three prime ministers. It's seen us lose our queen, who's been on the throne for 70 years. And that's been very disorientating. There's a kind of a feeling of a sense of an era has ended and we've now entered into a new one. This week, this year has really been hard work. I don't know about you, but personally I've felt God really on my case and really making some changes, some deep changes. As we look back today at what God has done, we can thank him for all that he has done with us this year. And as we go into 2023, we can go and we can see the giants, the challenges that are ahead of us with a sense of faith and hope rising up in us.
Thank you.
Get a real sense that hope and faith are rising within you for what the new year brings. And I've put together a little collection of all our highlights over this past year. There are some things that we've missed in this, but I've tried to collect as many photos and videos and that kind of stuff to give you a really good idea and to celebrate what's gone on in 2022. What's not included was, you know, in March, we took a group to the Billy Graham event, which was, you know, attended by thousands. We saw several hundred people get saved at that. And it was good to be a part of that as a church. I know one or two of you brought family members and that sort of thing to that. We've had a busy year. We've had some great speakers come and speak to us. I can think of, Gustav and Ruth have done some speaking to us. We've had Keith Dowling come. We've had Tim Grant come and speak to us. We've had Dave Latham. And it's been great. Everyone who has come has really spoken to what we're doing and really sort of built into what we're doing. So here are those highlights.
Also, when I obey God, what does that do? When you find your place, guess what? Other people around you find their place. We realize the enormity of that. It's like it's almost like God says to Abraham, every family on earth is going to be blessed because of you. Woo-hey! Now take your son up the mountain and kill him. Well, does that mean if I don't obey you, every family on earth is going to miss out?
Elijah, and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace.
So Elijah, we just want to bless you, and we just bless you in the ways of the Lord, that you would grow up a strong and mighty warrior of the Lord. In Jesus' name.
We're going to baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, in the name of the Holy Spirit, in the name of the Father.
What you can do, oh God of wonders, your power has no end. The things you've done before, in greater measure, you will do again. There's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can move, all things are possible. There's no broken body you can raise, no so that you can say all things are possible. But the darkest night, you can light it up, you can light it up. Oh God, have revival, let hope arise. Death is overcome, you've already won. God, have revival. You rose in victory, and now you see forever on the throne. So why should my heart fear what you've defeated? I will trust in you alone. Cause there's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can move. All things are possible. There's no broken body you can raise, no soul that you can save. All things are possible. The darkest night, you can light it up, you can light it up. God, have revival, hope arise. Death is overcome, you've already won. God, have revival. Come awaken your people, come awaken your city. Oh God, have revival, pour it out. Pour it out. Every stronghold will crumble. I hear the chains hit the ground. Oh God of revival, pour it out. Pour it out. Come awaken your people. Come awaken the city. Oh God of revival, pour it out. Pour it out. Every stronghold will crumble. I hear the chains hit the ground. Oh God, our revival, pour it out, pour it out. Darkest night, you can light it up, you can light it up. Oh God, our revival, let hope. Oh, love refined. Whoa.
It would break my heart. am just bringing a short word today, just partially about where God is leading us for 2023 and very much what God has put on my heart. Now, if you've heard me preach in the last sort of 4 weeks or so, you've probably heard part of this, but it's just kind of a few things coming together just of where God is leading us in 2023. You know, a few weeks ago, God woke me up with some words, and I don't have the time to unpack it all today, but I just wanted to start with that. And it says, "The Spirit of the Lord says, you can no longer build from or in a place of compromise and expect me to bless it. Gray is no longer a color option if you are wanting to see my kingdom built. You can no longer sit quietly building with others whose belief systems are rooted in the kingdom of darkness. Slowly, slowly, bless with kindness is no longer the way. 2023 is a year of extremes and suddenlies. This is a start of a new season. Radical Christianity is needed. Building kingdom no longer looks like finding middle ground." I just really want to bless you into this for this season, because we're no longer in the middle ground zone. We're no longer in the bit where it's a bit gray, we're not really sure. This next season is a season of you're either in or you're out. And we need to decide where we are. You know, our God is still a faithful God. In 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 9, it says that God is faithful. I will go and read that to you now. It says, "God, who has called you into fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, is faithful." You know, there are many places in the Bible that talk about the faithfulness of God. And, you know, that's just one of the places. And I have been speaking about not about the faithfulness of God, but our faithfulness to God. You know, in Hebrews 11, there's a whole long list of people that are said to have been faithful to God. And God lists them almost. It's like the, you know, who's who of faithfulness. And our determination for 2023 really needs to look like, how are we faithful to God? Are we going to continue to move up and down? He loves me, he loves me not. He loves me, he loves me not. Or, God, if you bless me in this way, or you do this for me, then I'll follow you. You know, we need to stop the bargainings with God. We are ultimately, we still want to see breakthrough. We need to, you know, pray and contest for that. But it should not waver our faithfulness to God, even when things perhaps don't turn out the way we'd hope or plan. You know, I really believe we're going to step into a time of suddenlies and extremes in the natural, and we should therefore expect it in the spiritual as well. And, you know, part of what I've been talking about is that we can't have this middle ground or the slow paced thing to things. You know, we as church leaders need to be sending you, and we're saying you are sent to your workplaces to be the salt and the light. And, you know, in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, I'm just going to read from verse 1. Now, this is Paul speaking. And he says, "When I came to you, brothers, I did not come with eloquence or superior wisdom, as I proclaimed to you the testimony about God. For I resolved to know nothing while I was with you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear and with much trembling. My message and my preaching were not with wise and persuasive words, but with a determination, with a demonstration of the Spirit's power, so that your faith might not rest on men's wisdom, but on God's power." And I think the key to this is we need to be coming back to the strength of God's power. He says, he did not come with persuasive words, but with a demonstration of the Spirit's power. How do we step into this next year in the demonstration of the Spirit's power? We have to start walking from a place of in the Spirit. And that means we need to start questioning things more. God, what are you saying here? What are you doing there? Then we have to have the boldness and the determination to demonstrate God's spiritual power by giving those words of knowledge, by having that strategy for somebody, by just releasing kingdom as we go. And, you know, he's saying he didn't come with all these fancy things, and he did come actually in weakness and fear and with much trembling. How often do we come to situations where we're feeling a bit like we're trembling, we're feeling a bit like we're a bit nervous and scared? But, you know, this next year is supposed to be a year where we step into boldness regardless of those feelings. It's not saying those feelings aren't going to be there. You know, Paul saying he has these feelings, but he was able to step out. And, you know, I do believe that by the end of 2023, we're going to have a situation where people that were strong in church, we're going to say, well, what happened to them? Why are they no longer with us? Why are they no longer following God? Because I think there has to be very much a clear cut in this next season where people are either in or they're out. They're for or they're against. There's not going to be any gray zone. And so, and I do think our resolve is going to be tested in this time. So where is our faithfulness to God, even when our resolve gets tested? You know, I was reading Jonah earlier, and Jonah's the one that he doesn't want to go and speak to Nineveh and tell them that God's going to destroy them if they don't turn to him. And he tries to run away and gets on a boat, and there's a big storm and they throw him out. We know he sits in a large fish for about 3 days. But when he gets to Nineveh eventually, and he says to them, you know, you have to turn to God, otherwise it's things are going to be bad for you. This place is going to be destroyed. You know, they all put on sackcloth and they call for a time of repentance and fasting, and they turn to the Lord. And, you know, I really believe that there has to be this boldness of, if you guys don't sort this out, God's going to come and bring judgment. And, you know, we obviously need to be sent by God. We need to know what he's saying. But I believe we're going to see many added to the kingdom this year as we demonstrate his power, as we tell people, you know, guys, you're doing this the wrong way. Look at Yahweh. He is the way. Look at his son, Jesus Christ. And we will see many who come to a place of repentance. You know, Christmas time is always a time for hope. And we very much speak messages and we hear messages of it's a time for hope and God's in all these things of hope for us. And that is very much true. But I really believe that this is now a time that it's no longer just a hope for us, but it needs to be a hope for others. And it cannot be a hope for others unless we are the ones that are going out and telling them about the hope in Jesus Christ. That requires maturity. That requires the body of Christ to suddenly grow up significantly. Because we like to be in a place where the church leaders tell us that there's hope in Jesus. There's hope in Jesus. And we move a little bit further, but we go around in some circles first and we take a few more steps forward. But we need to be the ones now that are bringing the hope to others. We need to be the ones that are saying, come on, there's hope in Jesus. That's not just my responsibility or Dan's or anyone else in the church, and not yours as well. It is your responsibility just as much as anyone else in your workplace, in your sphere of influence. You are the sent ones. You are the one that has to go out and say, I am following Jesus and there is hope and I'm going to pray for you. And, you know, I was saying the other day, I hate it when people say, oh, I'm praying for you. It almost feels a little bit derogatory, like I'm praying for you. And you think, are you really praying for me? You're just saying that because you want me off your back. And I very much have put myself in a position now that if I type those words to somebody and say, I'm praying for you, I better flippin' well get on and actually pray. Not just say that I'm praying, but actually do it. And so I want to encourage us that we need to be asking God these questions. God, what is the strategy? When somebody tells you a story that seems so hopeless, what is the answer, Lord? Because you are the hope. So, you know, yes, it's great that we pray, But we need to be praying, God, give us strategy for this person. Help us to help them, you know, so that you can go back to that work colleague and say, you know, that sounds awful. I don't really know what to say, but you know what? I'm going to pray and I'm going to ask God if he has a strategy. And then you go and you spend time praying and you ask God. You know, it might be that you have to do something to help them, but maybe it's just a case of they need to do X, Y, Z, or you need to pray something specific into a situation. You know, it is time for us to take that responsibility and no longer just put it on our church leaders. And we will see the suddenlies happen and we will see the extremes happen in both directions, not just from a place of the bad and the sense of all the things that are, that might happen in our nation this year. But actually, we should be seeing the positive things of God, where we're able to see somebody healed that we didn't think was going to be able to be healed, or there was just no hope for the situation, but you came in and you prayed and you asked God what to do and he showed you, and suddenly there was breakthrough for someone. You know, we need to be the carriers of the hope and the carriers of the suddenlies, no longer just for ourselves but for others around us. So I just want to bless you into boldness for this next season, this next year, where you're going to step in to all that God is calling you to, where you're going to start to ask the questions and you're going to see people transformed and changed in the suddenlies of God, where he suddenly comes upon a situation and repentance takes place, where he suddenly comes into a situation and a healing takes place. And people are going to say, oh, how did you do that? Where did you do that? They say, my God is all that I need. You know, in that scripture in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, Paul says, I made it my business just to focus on Jesus Christ when I was with you. That needs to be our focus this year. Our focus on him, so that we can be that salt and that light to others, that we can bring those strategies in, that we can be the hope, the Jesus hope. So I bless you with that. I hope you've had a wonderful Christmas. I bless you into 2023, and I will see you soon.
Thank you all for watching. It's been great to have you with us. I hope you enjoyed that message by Kim. And I hope that you know, you enter 2023 full of hope and full of faith for what God's going to do with us in the future. Bless you. We'll see you on New Year's Day at 2 p.m. at Jed and Yvonne's house. It'd be great to see you there. But we'll look forward to catching up with you into 2023.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año a felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año a felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año a felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año a felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart.